Hello. In this video, we will learn about factors that shift oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. First, we will see what exactly does a shift in curve means in terms of binding or dissociation of oxygen with hemoglobin. Then we will see different factors that shift the curve and their importance. Let's get started. First, let's revise oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. In previous video, we have seen that increasing partial pressure of oxygen increases hemoglobin saturation with oxygen. The graph of partial pressure versus oxygen saturation looks like this. Here, x-axis shows partial pressure of oxygen, and on y-axis, we have saturation of hemoglobin. The curve is sigmoidal or S-shaped. It is steep in middle part. At this range, small change in partial pressure of oxygen can cause relatively large change in hemoglobin saturation. And it is flat at the beginning and at the end. At these areas, changes in partial pressure of oxygen causes smaller change in saturation as compared to middle part. Now some factors decrease affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. So in presence of such substances, less oxygen binds with hemoglobin at same partial pressure. This results in rightward shift in oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. See, this is the initial curve in absence of that factor. Here, this much oxygen pressure was causing this much saturation of hemoglobin. And this is the curve in presence of that angry substance. Here, same partial pressure of oxygen is causing less saturation of hemoglobin. This is because decreased affinity. In simple words, rightward shift in the curve simply means the affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen is decreased. Now let's see opposite type of people. In presence of some substances, affinity of hemoglobin is increased. So more oxygen binds at same partial pressure. This results in left shift of the curve. See, here same partial pressure that we were talking earlier causes increased hemoglobin saturation. Thus, leftward shift means affinity of hemoglobin is increased. To summarize what we have seen so far, rightward shift means decreased affinity and leftward shift means increased affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. Now let's see what these factors actually are. First, factors that shift the curve to right. These are increased temperature, increased partial pressure of carbon dioxide, increased hydrogen ion concentration, and 2,3-diphosphoglycerate. All these factors decrease affinity of hemoglobin. These first three factors help deliver more oxygen to peripheral tissues. And 2,3-DPG is important in adaptation to hypoxia. Let's see detail of these factors first. Okay, so here we have lungs, blood vessels, and peripheral tissues. At lungs, hemoglobin loads oxygen, goes to periphery, releases some oxygen, and comes back to lung to load more oxygen. As we have seen in first video of oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve, at lungs, partial pressure of oxygen is high. So loading of oxygen increases hemoglobin saturation here. And at peripheral sites, partial pressure of oxygen is low. So oxygen is released and saturation decreases. Now due to metabolic activity, temperature, carbon dioxide, and acid levels are high at peripheral sites. All these factors decrease affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. So at peripheral sites, oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is shifted to right. This is a good thing because now the equilibrium is achieved at lower point. Here saturation is lesser, which means more oxygen is released. See, without shift, hemoglobin would release only this much oxygen. But due to right shift, hemoglobin now releases even more oxygen at same partial pressure. This increased release of oxygen by carbon dioxide and hydrogen is also called Bohr's effect. At lungs, situation is different. Here, all three factors, temperature, carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration are low due to ventilation and washing out of carbon dioxide. So the curve is on left side. As compared to right-sided curve, This leftward position here helps loading more oxygen at same partial pressure. However, in quantitative terms, this increase in loading is less as compared to extra unloading at peripheral sites. The reason is, towards high partial pressure, the curve is flat. So impact of shift is relatively small. At middle range, the curve is steep. So impact of changes are larger here. If we combine both the graphs, this is the collective picture. Due to shift in oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve, the equilibrium shifts between these two points. At lungs, leftward position of curve helps load more oxygen, and at peripheral sites, rightward position of curve helps release more oxygen. Thus, total oxygen delivery is increased. Without the shift, this amount would be less. I hope you are getting all the points. Now let's move to 2-3 DPG. In this diagram, I am showing RBC as middleman between lung and peripheral tissue. In RBC, 2-3 DPG is produced during glycolysis. Its level is increased in hypoxia. It decreases affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. So the dissociation curve is shifted to right. How this affects transport of oxygen? See, without DPG, this was the set point. In presence of DPG, now it is at lower level. Means hemoglobin saturation is decreased at same partial pressure. However, the curve is flat in this area. So this decrease in loading of oxygen is very small. On the other hand, at peripheral sites, the curve operates at steep middle portion. Here, without DPG, unloading is this much. But in presence of DPG, there is marked increase in oxygen release. Look here, this is the quantity that is delivered without 2-3 DPG. And this is the quantity delivered with 2-3 DPG. Clearly, more oxygen is delivered in presence of 2-3 DPG. Yes, with DPG, loading is slightly compromised, but it is more than compensated by increasing unloading. So overall delivery of oxygen is high. In this way, increased 2-3 DPG level in hypoxia helps oxygenate peripheral tissue better. These were the factors that shift the curve to right. Now let's see a factor that shifts the curve to left, carbon monoxide. Once again, I am showing only RBC. Carbon monoxide here increases affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. In presence of carbon monoxide, hemoglobin loads oxygen at lungs, but due to very high affinity, it does not release oxygen at peripheral tissues. So tissues are deprived of oxygen, resulting in serious damage or even death. The curve in this case looks like this. At lungs, hemoglobin gets saturated, but at peripheral sites, there is hardly any change in saturation level. It stays high due to high affinity, indicating almost no release of oxygen. So these were the factors that shift oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. You can watch other videos on respiratory physiology from channel page. I have mentioned some links in description. Also follow me at other social media platforms. If you are new here, subscribe to be a part of Nonstop Neuron family. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.